If you take bishop into e6, interesting move. We should.
No. The following procedure.
Yeah, let's try to calculate. Bishop into e6.
King into
e6.
King
g6. King g6.
B4.
G6. F5. Very good. Now what?
King e7.
Okay, now you have to. Can everyone follow this analysis? Or no? How many of you can follow? Bishop into e6. King into e6. King g6. Did you see this?
Yes.
Both of you, yeah? It's a draw?
Yes.
Or it's winning for white? Or black is winning? Anything can happen. It's a race. Okay. B4 is forced. You push the pawn. I play f5. Check. It's lost. What's your name?
Akshat.
Akshat is saying it's lost. But to for whom?
Black.
Black is losing. Okay. Anyone who thinks black is not losing?
No!
Black is not losing.
Okay, what will you play?
King
E5. Okay. King E5. Okay. King E5, F6.
B3.
F7.
B2.
F8.
B1 check and draw.
No. Okay, now Gukesh here, who has played the game, he says if king e5, not to push f pawn, but to push h pawn. Did anyone think of this move?
No.
Why? Because you have b3, h6, b2, h7, b1 queen.
Check.
And
check.
Queens with a check. What is this position?
White.
This is a theoretically winning position for white.
Black king should be on
S1
or
A. Black. Okay, Gukesh says that the king here should be on here, somewhere here, yeah? Or I would say better, maybe even this side, somewhere. Safe. But anyway, this is completely winning because your king, queen and the pawn are so nicely coordinating that you can push it ahead. Yeah?
But if my king is
on it. Okay. We'll come to it. So you understand that pawn endings are not very simple. Okay? Let's go back. This is a game where in order to take the knight on e6, you have to calculate very, very hard. So, but we should, bishop into e6, king into e6, king g6. Now, black pushes b4, f5, black to play. What will you play?
King
d7, how many king d7?
King
d7? No. Black has to draw somehow. You need to draw, otherwise you won't become national champion. Go back, flashback, okay? How will you draw this game? What should black play? King e5, we just analyze. It's losing. h5, h6, h7 with a check. King c, d7, you
King
d5, how many king d5? King d5, how many king d7?
King
d5. King d7. How many? King
e7.
Only one point.
King
d5. King e7. What's your name?
Rashi.
You want to put your king in check? I will push my pawn with check. So you are also a chess player. Good. So, first of all, when we play, we often discount some moves, okay, listen, we often don't consider some moves because it's check or something like this. So king e7 looks like a wrong move, Why to play king e7? f6 will come with a check.
King g7
will come, see, as he says. So, let's first see the other two suggestions. King to d7. Okay? Lot of people said king d7. Yes, sir. What did you say? King d7. Now, can anyone tell me what is the problem with this move?
H5, B3, H6, B2, H7, B1, B8.
How about playing F5, F6? F6, B3, F7, B2, F8, Queen, B1, check, Queen, F5, check. Queen, F5, King, F5, King, E8. King, E7. King, G6. King, F8. And draw. Once the king reaches f8 or f7, it's a draw. So, this might not be such. So, in order to play for a win here, you might have to push h5. But as we discussed before, there is a high chance that this will end in a win for queen and queen. Both sides queen.
It comes checks.
And check, this should be winning. What do you think?
Winning?
Yeah, yeah, because I have a feeling if you give this check over here.
Queen G1.
Okay, my.
King F7.
Then you go King F7 with no checks. Yes, now Bharat says interesting move over here is
king d5.
When you give a check to play king d5, what is the problem here?
F6, B3, F7, B2, F8.
So here, this is working. F6.
This is a winning for white.
Yes, this is winning for white. B3.
After queen f5, the queens are exchanged.
Exactly. Very good. F8 queen. B1 queen. And now it's a check for white, but counter check on f5. And after I take, king takes, this is
winning.
White is winning. So the only move for black to actually make a draw here is King E7. Good move. And after King E7, this is a draw. Why? Because if you play F6, I go King F8. Actually, this is winning for black. If you play King G7, I play B3.
F6.
And now where will you get your king?
E6.
I'm a very tricky man.
D7.
E6. F7. Queen. And now this position is a draw. Why? Because H pawn is much weaker than the F pawn. You are left with an H pawn here. So this is a theoretical draw. Okay. Now, in order to understand such a position here, the decision to take on E6 or not, you have to calculate how many moves are ahead. Nearly 20 moves are ahead. Yeah? Not easy. And how much time did you have?
1 minute.
1 minute. And you?
1 minute.
Both were on 1 minute. So you see, chess is very difficult. Because with less time, you cannot calculate everything. I'm sure there are many parents here who said to their kids that why didn't you calculate this move or that move? Has that happened?
Yes.
Everyone, I'm sure everyone has said, my parents also used to say.
Yes.
But if you look at this, chess is so complicated. And you have a clock ticking by. Time is running out. You don't have enough time. It is really difficult even for a player like Anand or Carlsen to do it. and these kids are improving, and so they have to learn all of this. So I just wanted to show even a game which is played by 2 10-year-olds can actually bring even a grandmaster or a top player difficulties in solving. Okay, I'm not talking about 1 minute. Even if someone takes half an hour to solve this, it's not easy. Yeah, agreed. This was not an easy decision to make. There are so many checks. By the way, here white is still winning in this position. Although we calculated to a draw after bishop into e6, if you make the move f5, white is winning, and this is beautiful. You know why? Because after the knight moves somewhere, king goes here, knight moves, you play f6, h5, the pawn on f6 and the bishop on a2, they create a barrier for the black king to come in, and then the h pawn just proceeds and white is winning. So even if you are just able to play knight c5, h6, it's just winning. Pawn queens, very difficult. Yeah, so Leon, you should have taken the pawn on h5, you would have won the game. It was very difficult, but yeah, with 1 minute I would say almost impossible. In the game, Leon played he played here king g6, and now Gukesh was able to draw very well. Yeah, this was good defense. He is now down
two pawns.
No,
three pawns.
Yeah, b2 pawn is there, but he's down 2 pawns, but anyway, this was a draw now. Okay, so very, very nice game. I would like all of you to give a big hand to these two kids. Yeah, sorry, oh, battery is running low. It's not charging. Now before we start something more, I would like to say that the players here, okay, each and every one of you has a possibility of becoming a GM. Okay, do you know why? Because I am myself very close to becoming a GM. Okay, I am an IM, international master, with 2 GM norms, okay, and with a rating of around 2400, so pretty close, yeah, you can say. But when my first nationals was under 12, because I started playing chess when I was 11, okay, so you can say that each one of you here is a much better chess player than I am. So all those who are thinking whether my kid will become a GM or whether I will become a GM, all of you think, of course you all can. Okay, the most important thing is to keep working on chess. Okay, and you have to keep working every day. How many of you love chess? Your mother made you put your hand up, yeah? Okay, so the thing is, if you love chess, okay, it means that when you have a choice to make between two things, you most of the times choose chess. Okay, so if there is a choice between going to a birthday party or practicing chess, you would much rather practice chess than go to a birthday party, because you love chess. Or if you had a choice between giving an examination in school or you had to go for a chess tournament, you would choose chess because you love chess. This is always a question for everyone here, the parents, that, you know, education and chess, this always it creates a problem. I don't think so, and I can say that with confidence because I myself am a chartered accountant. Okay, so the thing is, chess is very good for your education, because
just one thing. There are many factors. Okay, many people say it increases my analytical skills. It increases decision making. It helps you to take losses. This is one of the biggest things, by the way. The kids who learn to lose here, they are just going to be quite, you know, they won't really get affected when things go up and down in future. This I can say for sure. But one thing which I think is the most critical, which chess helps and is very logical, no one can argue with it, is it increases concentration. Just imagine you're sitting at a board for 4 hours doing absolutely nothing else but thinking. Yeah, I know some of you are daydreaming also, but most of the times you try to calculate, yes? And this helps you to improve your concentration, and sometimes you have 2 rounds in a day. That means you are concentrating for 8 hours nearly. And if there is 30 second increment, it can even go sometimes to 10 hours. I have had days when you were playing chess for 10 hours. Now, this scenario, when I was studying for my CA final exams, I would sit in a library, open my books and start studying. While the people next to me after an hour would say, okay, bahut ho gaya, chai peene jaate hai. You know, let's go and have some relaxation after 1 hour or 2 hours. Well, for me, it was very natural to sit for at least 4 to 5 hours. Yeah. So I would say chess helps in education tremendously if you can balance each other well. Yeah. I would also say at some point that you also need to make a decision between the two. This is very critical. I never made a very strong decision that I want to leave studies. I did make a strong decision after becoming a CA that I want to leave CA and I want to pursue chess. Okay? But if any of you and your parents, you think that your child is capable of doing something, is showing that interest, then you should make this bold decision at some point to play chess more.
I have already taken a 40.
You have already taken?
Yeah. 1 year. Completely. We are not.
You have taken 1 year off?
Yes.
Okay.
No. Not 1 year.
Then?
Completely off.
You're homeschooling?
No homeschooling. Totally dedicated for the chess only.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, that's wonderful to know. So this gentleman here with his son have taken complete off from school to just pursue chess. Yeah, it's excellent decision. How did you get this courage to do it?
I believe what you love, you do. First thing is that. Don't get underestimated by the system which is designed by anybody. If your child is interested in one thing, you should follow him. You should not follow him. That is the main point of my thinking about the career. So I allow my child what he love, he like, he can follow. I take decision, he take decision, our family take decision, and now we are on the track. That's it. That's all. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. Yes.
From all the parents to you.
Okay.
Suppose you would have taken this decision before becoming CA.
Yes.
Right in the 10th or 12th.
Yes.
What would have been your career like now?
So I'm just thinking about this all the time.
Yeah.
Because imagine when I became a CA, I was 2200. I think that I should have been much better at that point.
24 and 26?
Yeah, you should be at least at some point. I mean, I can't say a number, that's the point. But if you see that your child is improving rapidly and he's gaining in rating, this can be a good decision to make somewhere around whenever you think comfortable, 8th, 9th, 10th.
But would you think you would have been career-wise better placed?
Okay, first of all, CA I'm doing nothing. The CA is helpful only when I give a lecture like this. So I can say I was a CA. I am right now a chess teacher in some ways. I am a journalist. I have a chess company, ChessBase India. So chess is supporting me entirely for my whatever income and everything. And I love chess. The biggest advantage, by the way, she is my wife. She is a former national champion, Amruta Mokal, under 16. She is very strong and she had beaten Humpy also when she was young. We have traveled to 25 countries in last 3 years because of chess. So I would say chess has given us our life.
And CAs are there, so many CAs who are doing practically nothing on this.
Well, I would say I went to the office for 2 months, but it was not something that I could sustain. It was too dull. There was no fun. Sometimes if this happens in your life, that something becomes boring, I think you should not pursue it. This is what I feel.
Great. Thank you.
So, thanks. Okay. So this was a general thing. If you would like some more advice on this, later on we could meet. I would now like to show you some more things about chess. Okay. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay.
What is your name?
Okay, just sit. It's not going to, the screen is not going to become smaller or anything. Sit. Okay, how many of you here know Pragnananda? I'm seeing some people don't know. You don't know Pragnananda? Really?
How many of you don't know Pragnananda?
Yeah, just let's put the hands up. You don't know Pragnananda? For knowing you put your hand. You don't know Pragnananda? Then you don't know, okay? You don't know?
I don't know.
So homework for you guys to know who is Pragnananda. Okay, he's a big man, he's around 35-40 years old.
He's 11 years old.
Okay, he's 12 years old and he is trying to become the youngest GM in the world. Okay, he has one GM nom also and I think he is very strong. Okay. He beat 3 GMs. If I play with him, I will lose all the games. Okay? I think overall, there is something to learn from Pragnananda for all of you. And that is, he never plays for results. Okay? He doesn't care for winning or losing. He doesn't care for GM title. He doesn't care for GM norm. What he cares for is making good moves. Okay, how many of you do that in your game? That win or lose, you are always happy. You're always happy win or lose. Okay, this is an attitude which takes time to come, because when you lose, it is obvious you will be sad. But you have to try and play the best moves in the position. So I will show you one game of Pragnananda here. Okay, I analyzed it. Okay, sit.
I think in endgame black had some.
You have seen this endgame, yeah?
Yes,
okay.
Sir, I have also. I think in the endpoint you have under-20.
Yeah.
Factory logic row. I think in endgame black had some garlic.
No. Okay. Now, let's look at this position. Okay?
First, why? Let all of you sit
can
down properly.
Can anyone sit down, please?
Be comfortable.
Can you all sit down?
Sit down.
Can you see this position? Can you see from there?
Yes.
Yes or no? Yes. Then although you can't see, can you go behind there? It's a better view from here. If you have a good eyesight, then go there. It is a better place to see. Because my voice is anyway loud to reach there. You can go there. Okay. This is a position that Pragnananda reached. As white against, no talking. Yeah. What happened? Okay, it doesn't matter. It's not a test. Pragnananda reached this position against Awonder Liang. Awonder Liang is one of the youngest grandmasters of America. Okay? Now, my question to all of you is white winning here or is it a draw?
Winning!
What's your name?
Subrat.
Subrat says because white has one knight extra is winning.
Good.
Logical. But did you see white has one pawn less?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay. How many of you think this is winning? How many of you think it is a draw? First win. How many of you think win? So how many of you think draw? Many number, yeah? You think it's a draw? You think it's... You have seen this?
I have seen.
By the way, how do you determine whether this is a win or a draw? Who will tell you? Sorry? If you calculate, there is a limit to what you can calculate. Okay? You cannot calculate until the end. And this position, definitely you can't calculate and say it's winning or losing. You need some knowledge, you need some prior information of what's happening. So, you go to your coach, okay? Who is your coach? Sorry? Gurpreet sir. So, you go to Gurpreet sir and you ask him whether this is winning or losing. If he knows, he will tell you. Suppose he doesn't know. Okay? What will you do next?
Analyze
how? And
turning on the
engine. No, so the engine is analyzing, not you. Engine is doing the work. You are only switching on the button. Okay, switch on the engine. Let's go out for food. Come back. Ah, winning. Okay. There's also a limit to what an engine can analyze. Okay.
If he tells wrong.
Yes, exactly. This is a very good question. What if the engine tells wrong? Not a bad question.
What is your name?
Subrat.
How old are you?
Six.
Okay. It's a very good question. What if the engine tells wrong? And this is something, a very deep question. Imagine you analyze something 4 years ago with an engine. Today's modern engine will give that move as a substandard move. What you thought was the best move back then. So you thought, arey, engine. Now you are in 2017. Imagine in 2020, the computer will say this move is not good. But right now you think it's good. So actually engines cannot be trusted upon fully. Although they are very strong.
What is the accuracy of engines?
Well, they have a rating. Yeah, they say that engines are rated 3400. So you can take him as just another player who is 500 points stronger than Magnus Carlsen. But there is a, he can still make mistakes at 3400. So this position here with the engine is not possible to solve because there is no concrete stuff happening. Like you can't say I will put my rook over here, then black has to play this. Black is saying I will put my rook on a7 b7 a7 b7, king on g7, and I will see what to do. I will maybe activate my rook from a1 to f1 and do these things. How are you going to win? So first of all, my question to you is how to solve such issues in chess. You all know, if I give you a position, white to play and win, you will either calculate or you will switch on the engine and get the answer.
Calculate!
Yeah, both can give you the answer. But such a position, neither calculation can give you an answer, nor an engine can give you an answer. Engine can guide you. Okay, this is the right way, this is the best move here, you need to make another 50 moves and then you can win. So what is the other way? You guys, what would you do? You all are experienced players. What would you do if you face such a situation? Calculate, but alone?
No.
Wait.
In a group.
Okay. You, what would you do? Anyone else has any idea?
We will plan
what to do. Agreed. You will plan. And I think... use your knowledge. How? From where? Which knowledge?
Material.
Chess books.
Chess books. Okay, if you have come across this exact position in the chess book and some good author has said it's winning, yes, you can get this. Okay, it's winning as said by so and so person in so and so book. Again, that is not something that you can trust 100%.
Logical thinking.
Okay. I have a feeling that all of this can give you a good idea into the position, but not a win, not a correct evaluation whether it's winning or not. Okay? So I have a suggestion for all of you, and this is something which you must all try. How many of you use ChessBase?
ChessBase
14?
14.
Okay. Now, I think logically all of you must be using ChessBase. Yeah, without ChessBase you can't prepare. If you have to look at your opponent's games, if anything you have to do, you have to use ChessBase. Otherwise, you are like a person who was in 1980s. He comes to the tournament with a bag of books, ECO it was called. He would open a book, he would say, oh, my opponent plays A20. But no, wait. How do I know how the opponent plays? So he goes to the arbiter, takes the score sheets, and then, so it's a big process. With ChessBase, you can actually prepare against an opponent. So everyone has ChessBase. In that, there is a function called report. Can you see here? Report.
Yes.
This tab. And in report, there is a button called as similar endgame. How many of you have used this button ever? You have used it? Very good. You have used it? Do you know what it does? You also used it? It's very good. What does it do? Three people have used it, so I think you have to help me here. It helps us to find similar endgames. Yeah, okay. Anything else? But you have not used it. How are you
if
telling?
If someone else has played it, it shows the position whether it's a win or draw.
Okay. First of all, ChessBase is a software. Okay. Inside it, you have the mega database. Okay. It's a database of 8 million games. How many is 8 million? How many zeros?
6 or 7,
he's saying, and you are a chess player. You have to be accurate. Come on.
9, 6, 6, 9, 8, 9, 8, 6, 6, 7.
How many 6?
6.
Okay.
7, 9.
Okay, all those who said 6 are right. Okay? 80 lakh games, basically. It has 8 million games, and this is from where the ChessBase software searches this endgame from this 80 lakh games, 8 million games. And then it finds you very similar endgames to study. Okay? And when it does that, you will be shocked to see so many games. Like for example, I just click here and you will see this game. Who are the two players? Can anyone read? Yifan and Stefanova. Okay? Yifan is the women's world champion, ex-world champion, but the strongest player in the world. And Stefanova was the former world champion. Just click on this position and you will see a very similar endgame that Pragnananda reached with Awonder Liang.
Yes,
see?
It's just same. The troopers that are...
It is completely same. That is what is so shocking about this. If you use this function, you will find games with so much similarity because 8 million games and you have only 64 squares. Yeah, there are possibilities that games can be similar, not exact same. Now you study this game. Okay, what did Ho Yifan do? Ho Yifan first pushed her kingside pawns, h4, g4. Yes. Yeah, okay, but they reach this similar position, g4, h4, if I'm not wrong, they reach this. And then, she brought the knight to e5 at some point,
slowly, and then she got her king in. A very difficult plan, and finally she was able to win this pawn endgame over here. Now, what is this? This is the start of your material, okay, which not engines can provide, nor any coach can provide, yeah? What you will get are similar games. Now sit and analyze these games. Study the moves, if I made a mistake or not. Did Stefanova do something wrong? And then you can actually get to the truth of the position. Did everyone understand? Any end games that you have played and you are not sure what is happening, click on similar end games. It is much better than using an engine. What is your name?
Abhijay.
Abhijay. When you go home, don't click on the engine. Do you do that? Yeah, I know you do. Which engine do you use? Stockfish. Use similar endgames function. What it does is, it gives you a material which is not analyzed. And you have to then analyze it logically, move by move. As he said, logical thinking. But for logical thinking, you need some material. And this you get from here. Okay? Alright. Now one last thing before we go for the prize ceremony. 3 minutes left. Is how many of you go to chessbase.in? Come on, I wanted more hands than when I asked, do you know Pragnananda? Okay, anyway, chessbase.in is a website named ChessBase India. I don't know if my internet is working. I think I have to click here, yeah? Ah, it asks for username password. I think
no,
we have this Geo, right?
It doesn't have battery, right?
I think it does. So, ChessBase India is a website where you get news. Now, today when you will go back, just give it some time and you will find the report or Indian players outside. Now, from there, what happened? You know?
I know one player.
Who?
Morphe.
Okay. Paul Morphe. Now, if you go to ChessBase India, then there is something that you can gain out of it. I'm going to show you how you can make use of time by studying from articles of ChessBase India. Okay? Let's see if I can. Okay, one second. Please sit. Please sit. If I can connect to... Okay. If I can connect to the internet, then we can all see something interesting. Let's hope that happens. Okay, it's connected. Fine. Let's say if it's working. When you open the website, okay, you get games. You get in any article, you get games, okay. Now you must download these games. If you look at it, there's a button over there called Save Game, okay. If you save that game and download it, and then you open it, it opens here. Okay, in ChessBase format. Now, this was a game that took place between, who is this white?
Sakshi
Chitlange versus black? Does everyone know that national premiere is going on?
Yes!
Where?
Gujarat!
Very good. You all are having great general knowledge.
So top 12 women players in India, you can say not all of them are participating, but some of the top players are playing over there to become the national women's champion. And we have a report there every day on it. So there is a game, you download it. Yes, you can follow chess. Now, when you download it, okay, please don't talk. You get this game here. I'm going to make a few moves, okay? And you have to tell me the name of this opening. Does everyone know?
Benoni.
Yes, it is Benoni. And Marianne Gomes, who is a very good player, she played the move Bishop G4. Okay, a little rare move. Okay, more common is Rook E8 or Knight BD7. Okay, now Sakshi played Knight to D2. Logical. She wants to bring her knight to
C4.
In the Benoni, the best square for your knight is
C4.
Why?
It attacks pawn.
D6 pawn is weak.
Exactly. D6 pawn is weak. You put your knight on C4, you attack it. What is another piece who can attack D6? Excellent. You all are very sharp. So this is what happened in the game. Queen D7 was played. Now this looks very funny, right? I was thinking black would have played knight bd7 or knight a6 or rook e8. What is the idea of queen d7?
Bishop h3
and d5. So suddenly black has two threats. Bishop h3
and
b5. So what should you prevent? What will you play? A4. How many will play A4? To stop B5, that is logical. So what will other people play?
A4.
You play A4, you will also play. Anyone else who can play something else? Bishop F3, I don't like so
much.
Rook E1 is interesting move because you want to play Bishop H3, Bishop H1. So that rook is not hanging. But to rook E1 comes B5. And black gets B4. And then he gets play on the queen side. So Sakshi played A4. Very good player. White player is playing very well. Now comes Bishop H3. If you take Bishop into H3, means you are inviting trouble.
Knight C4,
good move.
I get Bishop F4.
Rook D8 now.
Bishop F4.
She took.
King D8.
And queen E7. Now comes the most important point of the game.
Knight B5.
Let's win a pawn, but let's give up a knight.
Queen E4 check.
Knight down. C4 is hanging.
Sir, but C7, knight C7, rook is
trapped. But then I just move knight A6 and I get two pieces for rook. Yeah, so what will you play here? Knight D6, rook D6, bishop D6, queen D6.
Rook E1.
King G1.
E4. But that is not better for white.
F3.
Okay, interesting move.
Queen D3.
King G1. You think like Sakshi. You also think like Sakshi. So you are thinking like a 20-50 player. Good. Now the thing is, King G1, although she played it, she wanted to play Knight B5, as all of you want to stop Queen E4 check. But the problem is, King G1 is too slow. It came Knight H5, Knight BD7, and suddenly black was developing everything. So you must try to find here, what is the mistake made by white?
F3.
F3 is a very logical move, in fact, here. And I would recommend that this is interesting. But after knight h5, I'm not sure what you will do. Because after bishop d2, I have a feeling that if f5 could also be possible. Then you have to be careful that I take here and then take on e4 with a check. Yeah, you will have compensation. I'm not saying this is bad. F3 is possible. But sit. You're tired, huh?
No, they're squeezing me.
They're squeezing you, okay.
Yeah, so.
Okay, the right move here is queen d2. Why? Because when he plays knight h5, you want to play bishop g5. Very strong move. Queen d2 is the most strong move in the position. Strongest move. If you can play queen d2, knight a6, now f3, as Bharat said, now you get everything. And after e4, white is completely winning. I mean, better, with a clear advantage. Now, I'll tell you this, that this game might not be a very high level game, okay? It was not played by, say, a grandmaster or a super GM who was about 2700. Nor was the game that we analyzed a few minutes back between Gukesh and Liang. These are all players who are around 2200, 2300. But analyzing these games is important. And how do you analyze? With your brain, yeah? Try to think. Why did white not get an advantage? What was the best move? Don't switch on engines just like that. Engines are your good friends, but only when you want to invite them, they should come. Yeah? They should not come uninvited to your home. Yeah, every time game ho gaya, how many of you, after losing a game, go home, switch on the engine and say, ye galti ho gaya tha, I should have played this move. I myself have done it. So I'm sure each one of you has done here. If you have not done it, continue. Don't do it. Try to first think of your mistake on your own and only then see it with the engine.
After the game, you clear it.
You?
After the game, we clear it.
You clear it?
Yes.
What? Clear what?
Mistake.
Okay, with how?
By board.
By board. Okay, okay. So, guys, this was a small lecture that I wanted to give. First thing is to look at games, to analyze them. Second is to use similar endgame function. There is also similar structure function next to it in ChessBase 14. All of you should try to use ChessBase 14, I think, because it has the latest features. If you are using ChessBase 12 or 13, go to ChessBase 14. If you are spending each and every day of your life learning chess, make use of the best software. And all those who would like to learn more things, we can do it. Well, I'm going to tell you my plan with Amruta. Okay? We have left home yesterday. So we were living in a rented place. And we gave that place up. So now someone else is staying. And we are going to travel India for 1 year. We are not going back home, so because we don't have a home. So we are in Pune right now at her place, her parents' place, just to say goodbye to them for 2 days. Then we are going to Surat for National Women's Premier. Then to Ahmedabad for World Youth Olympiad. Then to Bhopal. After that to Mumbai. Then IIFL. Then from there to Chennai Open. Delhi Open first. Then Chennai Open. And then national schools, maybe national team championship. I'm sure we are going to meet at various tournaments. Whenever you have some questions, come ahead, ask us. And if you have any questions right now, you should ask me through my email address, which is chessbaseindia@gmail.com. Okay, go chessbaseindia@gmail.com. Very easy to remember, chessbaseindia@gmail. Ask any questions, they will be answered. Yeah, the main idea is for all of you to improve at chess.